personally speaking, definitely some kind of regulation should be there, but that regulation should be reasonable and should be in consultation with the hospital and doctors. So that is one thing which is very clear. But as far as this bill is concerned, I will like to tell you, one of our previous guests, he has said that this sector is largely unregulated. I will like to point out certain facts that this sector is absolutely regulated. I can tell you no hospital can charge more than MRP. No hospital can charge more than the list of the procedures and the list of the charges displayed at reception. Every hospital is supposed to be displaying the, every registered hospital is supposed to be displaying the list of the charges. So there are a lot of regulatory mechanisms. As far as the imprisonment of the doctors is concerned, I can tell you, lot many doctors have been imprisoned and there are a lot of acts which are against the doctors. So this sector saying that it is unregulated, it is not unregulated. It is regulated by lot
yes,
of, if we talk of a particular case, you know, we can go to the depth of the detail of the billing process. If supposingly the charges have been more than MRP, or if supposingly some unethical kind of prescription has been done, even criminal action can be slapped on the hospital, on any hospital whichever is there. So it is a question of the laws are already there, they are in place, and the doctors and hospitals are already regulated. Still we welcome if there is a reasonable fine tuning in the rates of the in the private sector, if the government, although if talking to other professionals, there is no regulation on the rates of any of other professional, may it be CA, may it be lawyer, may it be an IT professional or a computer professional or anybody. There is no regulation as far as the rates are concerned. But still as medical fraternity, if the public at large, secondly, government must do lot of things. They should do the exercise and see what these corporate hospitals are making. They should see their balance sheets and see, are they making humongous profits or they are just barely selling out in the sector. So there are a lot of things to be done. Secondly, it is very important suggestion by one of the panelists that we should strengthen the government hospitals. Why should the people be only at the mercy of the big public sector healthcare facilities? So it is very important for the government. There were many objections. Number one, if a doctor is scared of being arrested at every drop of the hat, there are so many laws otherwise also to deter the doctor, he can be arrested. So if there is a deterrence of that sort, even the Apex Court, Supreme Court, in one of the prime judgments in which came in 2005 has mentioned that if a professional is scared, he will not be able to discharge his duty properly. I can tell you that I also deal with so many patients who are sick as a pediatrician. So we need to take so many decisions whether to shift the patient to ICU or not, whether the patient to put on ventilator or not. There are so many clinical dilemmas. So if the doctor is scared of taking the clinical dilemmas, then it will be very difficult.
And, let me bring in other voices.
I don't agree with Dr. Saab. I will tell you, our right now president, who is Dr. K.K. Agarwal, he is not owning his hospital. The secretary, Mr. Tandon, is not owning any hospital. Majority of the people are not hospital. Rather, I will differ in this way, because the people who are owning their hospitals or who have stakes in the hospitals, they hardly have any time to devote to IMA, because you have to devote a lot of time onto IMA. I am not able to understand certain things. Number one, why it is downwatering of this act? Just because a doctor is not sent to the jail after redressal inquiry by a Jilla Panchayat head who doesn't know what the medical science is.
We're talking about, I am not able to understand. We're talking about capping of the fees, Dr. Malik.
Secondly, yes. we need to Yeah, I'm coming to capping of fee, ma'am. Number one thing is, as far as the capping of fee is concerned, gentleman Mr. Rajiv has rightly pointed out that the people, the hospitals who have taken the land from government, they need to definitely give services to the lower socioeconomic strata or free of cost or this thing. I fully agree with him. But what, is there not a constitutional dilemma where the people who have their own hospitals, who have made their own hospitals without taking land from the government, how can government regulate them? Number two, a professional who has done good labor, I'm just talking, not as a layman I'm talking, not as a representative from any organization or as a doctor, I am not able to, I have not got any answer from any of the panelists. Are you regulating? There are so many poor people who are not able to get justice because of the high fee of the lawyers. Are you also capping the fee of everybody, every CA, every lawyer, every this thing? Is there not a constitutional dilemma? But still, we still, all the doctors, we respect that there should be a reasonable control on the fee structure of the doctors. We fully welcome. In Karnataka, are you putting a regulation in Karnataka? You are putting a regulation on every profession.
No, there should be. As per the NABS
guidelines, every hospital is supposed to be telling.